because I'm allergic, you know? Every time I drink it, I break out the handcuffs, so... The cops told me over, they're like, we're gonna have to give you the breathalyzer test, Mr. Redwater. I was like, there's no way I'm gonna pass that. I was surprised. And it turns out I was wrong, because I got a 4.0 on that test.
When I caress your profile against the high noon sun, it's to remind you that you're different because you've always been the same. Stitch me to my origins. Tell me a story of our beginning again. How beautiful to never search for who you are, even if you're not always sure. Because no one can disturb the way that prayers are the verbs that shape our world. Or the work that runs blood vessel deep to keep us in sync with the roots of our herringbone reach. Everything you need is here, in the millenniums of certainty living in your mirror.
So, I read a book recently by Greg Palast, who is one of the greatest investigative journalists out there, and I highly encourage you to check him out. And he was talking about voter disenfranchisement, specifically amongst Native Americans, the Hispanic population, and African Americans. This is what they reported. People showed up to the polls. They voted for judges, city councilmen, congressmen, but they didn't mark who they wanted for president. That seems a little weird to me that 700 people showed up to the polls and took the time out of their busy lives to vote for every other name on that sheet, but not mark who they wanted for president, and they all happened to be Native American. Or they all happen to be Latino. That's not, we're living in a world where these things happen and they get by and they're not being talked about. That's not democracy. We're not living in a democracy, we're living in an oligarchy. Or a plutocracy. And that's the truth. You can't argue with those facts. So it's our responsibility as servants to our future generations, as servants to our ancestors, to stand up. Yes. To stand up and say enough is enough. And the way that that happens is by going out. If every single person in this room encouraged 10 new people to vote, then there's like 200, 300 people in here. That's 3,000 new voters.
Hi everyone, my name is Joey Montoya, live on Apache from the Pond Apache Band of Texas, born and raised in San Francisco, California. I was talking to my brother, Ike Wishite, and he was telling me this story about Tecumseh and how far east, like way back when, he was trying to gather the tribe together to fight. And what he did is he pulled up this arrow. This is one arrow represents, you know, your tribe represents one tribe. And what he did, he snapped it, you know, broke that one tribe. And then he grabbed a bundle of arrows. And then he tried to break those, but they wouldn't break, you know. And those bundle of arrows, they represent each one of us, you know. It doesn't matter, not only red, you know, not only Native people, but it represents, you know, every ethnicity out here. And it represents all that, and it also shows that we have to come together, you know, as just one people, you know, all come together and vote for Bernie Sanders.
Thank you. together. And for good weather, I wrote the snow as a reminder. But in my own needle, there's a future. We can believe it. There's a future. We can believe it. Rain comes.